Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel Leela Web Dev. In the previous video, we have seen how to install the ESLint package in the Angular 12 version we have seen. Now, in this video, we will see how to install this ESLint. So that means in the prior to that Angular 12 version, we'll be having Angular. So some people will be using this Angular 11, Angular 10 or something like that from Angular 2 to 11. Okay, Angular 12 we have seen. But if you want to use this ESLint library in the Angular 11 version or anything, so prior to Angular 12 means how to install. Okay, why? Because I want to tell you is already ESLint library will be present in this Angular 11 or 10 version, right? So there will be no ESLint library. There will be already you will be having a ESLint version, and that is also deprecated one. Now how to convert that ESLint to the ESLint? Let's try to see in this video. Now I have so right now I am having the latest Angular CLI, right? Right now when I am doing this video, so the version of the Angular is 12. So when I install this through the Angular CLI, I will be getting this Angular 12 version. So that for that one, we don't have any ESLint or anything. So we have directly what we can say, we don't have anything. We need to install ESLint directly. Now let's go to the Angular CLI. Okay, I have already installed it. So if you want to install the older version, how to install it, I am trying to tell you here. Let's go to this GitHub. So Angular CLI you are having, yeah, here you will be able to see this Angular CLI releases. Now what I want to do is, so here if you want to install Angular CLI releases, so here right now it is having 12.1.0. so 12.01, 0.5 is the latest version. If you want to go to the previous versions, means just go directly like this, 11.2.14, so like this you are having, right? 12.0.23. so here you will be able to see something like so like this you are able to see these are all the versions. You'll be able to see all these what we can say releases, right? You can take any version, something like yeah, 11.2.13, something like that. You can take like this and you can install it using how we can install it is npm install. First uninstall the Angular CLI whatever you are having, and you can do angular/cli and you can give something like version here. Okay, so like this you can install it. Now I have already installed one version, so I will show you npm version. So if you sorry, not npm version, ng version. Okay, so Angular is the ng, right? Ng version, it will give you the Angular CLI. Now normally in the Angular, how you will be having is the Angular CLI version one, it will be one and the same with the Angular version. Okay, so you can think that if Angular CLI is the 12, means you can think that the Angular CLI, it will be installing the Angular 12. If it is 11, means it will install the 11. So right now I am having this Angular here. These are all the things is 11.0.1. Okay, so I am installing the 11.0.1. And here if you want to install project, means what is the common command is angular-bold. Right now I am taking angular-bold. Now let's try to see how it will install. So let's it install. So it will take some time to install. It is asking some questions. Okay, so type yes. Yeah, I want the Angular routing. Okay, take the routing CSS. Okay, now let's see whether it will install or not. Yeah, it is trying to create the install the packages. So let it install the packages. Now I got an error. So it is telling the schematic workflow failed, something it is saying. So let's try to see what is the error we are having. It is telling that it has found the Jasmine core 3.6.0 in this Angular CLI old version, but what it is telling is it needs something like greater than or equal to Jasmine core 3.7.1, something it is saying. So it is telling that in the Angular CLI, the version what I have installed, it is saying that the Jasmine core, it is there is 3.6.0, but in order to install you need to have 3.7.1, it is saying. Okay, let's see, let's remove this what I can say the whatever the created. So I am removing this folder. Now again I am installing this one, so I am skipping the installation. So installation of the npm, so just try to create it like this directly. So now without doing the npm install, it will create the Angular project. After that we will need to do the npm install. Why? Because right now the version we are having Angular CLI is 12 version or something related, so I have forcibly shifted to the Angular 11 version. Maybe some package mismatch will be there. So now let's create the Angular project like this without doing the npm install. Right now what I will try to do is, what is the error it has showed is Jasmine core version, it should be 3.7.1, it should not be 3.6.0, something like that it is saying. Okay, so now it is installed. So let's go to the angular-bold. Now I will try to open this one in the Visual Studio Code. Let's open this one in the Visual Studio Code. Now I have opened this project in the Visual Studio Code. Now here you will be able to see the tslint.json file has been created. Why? Because we are having the version Angular 11, not Angular 12. In the Angular 12, we don't have any tslint or anything. Now here, if you open this package.json, so here you'll be able to see Angular animations, Angular core, everything is the 11. Now the error what we have got previously, it told that in the dev dependencies, we are having a Jasmine core of 3.6.0. We need something like 3.7.1, something it is saying. Okay, let's try to change it to 3.6.0. And here also I will have 3.7.1. That's it. So now let's try to do the Angular npm installs. Normally this will not happen. So for me, why it has happened is, so right now we are in the Angular 12, right? So I have shifted back to the Angular 11 version. So that is the reason, maybe it could have come something like that. So normally if you get like this, any npm version errors or anything, so you can do like this. So let's try to do the npm install. Npm install is done. Now what I want to do, so now we will run the now if I open here in the tslint.json, we are having like this, right? If you go to the angular.json or package.json, you'll be having the linting command. So lint, it is ng-lint it is running. If you try to go, so that in the tslint.json, the extents is the tslint recommended, and it is using the rules directory Codalyzer. Codalyzer is one of the tools, something like what we can say is something like how what we have the Airbnb, these type of rules we are having, right? So code, they will be using the in the tslint Codalyzer. Codalyzer will have all the rules that are needed for this Angular, and these are all the some of the commands, same things, rules, how we need to do. So these are all the rules it is available. Okay, so now what we need to do, we have already the tslint json file. Now we need to convert it into the ESLint. How we can convert? Now if you try to go into this Angular ESLint, if I go to the Angular ESLint and if I try to press the command, and here if you try to see, quick start with Angular before version 12. So before version 12 we need to do, and here if you try to see, so this is the command we need to enter. So now let's copy this command. Okay, I have copied this command, and go to this Angular old project. So whatever the project you are having, so now let's paste it here. Okay, what is this one, didn't copy it or what? Let's copy. Okay, let's copy it. Okay, it's copied. Now let's go here and paste it. Yeah, so press enter. Same thing, Angular ESLint hyphen schematics. So this one will install all the ESLint required plugins, everything it will install that is required for this Angular. So now it is taking, it is asking some reports. Okay, fine. Yes, let's press enter. Okay, so let it install. It may take some time to install. So before installing this one, I need to explain you one thing. And if you come here, so supported here, you will be able to see this version support. If you open this one in version support, you will be able to see that. So what are the Angular ESLint, what are the versions it will be supporting? Angular CLI versions, what are the CLI versions it will be supporting? It is telling. Now current is V12 and later. It will support version 12 and later. Now if you are having prior to version 12, so that means if you are using not version 12, version 11 or 10 or 9 or something like that, if you are using means. So now what they have given is, so here they are telling that in order to support the major version alignment to make much simpler, Angular ESLint, we jumped from major version. So previously the Angular ESLint version was 12, it has jumped directly to 12 it seems. Okay, so that means 5 to 11 it doesn't exist. And this makes the version element prior to version 12 a little harder to follow by comparison. So that means it will be very difficult. So you may think that, so okay, for Angular 11 I need to install Angular ESLint 11, for Angular 10 I need to install, for Angular ESLint, like that it will be not there. Now you need to understand that Angular ESLint versions prior to version 12, that means greater than or equal to 2, less than 12. So whatever the version greater than or equal to 2 and less than 12, so Angular ESLint will work. And you need to understand that we support Angular CLI 11.2.0 up until, okay. So that means until, so from version 2 to 11.2.0 it will support. You cannot, the Angular ESLint will not support something like 11.2.4, 11.2.6, 11.2.7, something you will be able to have, right? 11.3.4. So those things will not be supported. We supported Angular 11 up until, but not including 12.0 means automatically you will be having 12 version. So you need to understand that for V version 1.x.x means for these packages, we supported Angular from 10.1.0 to 11.1.0. So that means up to 11.1.0 it is supporting. Why does Angular version support to? So this is the thing you need to understand. Up to 11.1.0 Angular ESLint will support. So from 11.1.0 to 12, it will not support. So maybe you may get some issues. So I don't know. So you may get some issues. So that is the reason. So I'm trying to explain to you. If you are having a project version of 11.2.3, something like that, if you are facing any problem, is so here you need to understand that. So these packages we support from 10.1.0 to 11.1.0, something they are saying. Okay. So that is the thing I want to explain to you. I want to make a note. Here we have installed the Angular schematics. Now what we need to do is, so after installing this one, let's go here, and here we need to use this command. Okay, so let's copy this command up to here. Okay, so let's copy this one and paste it here. So I am using this command, so ngg angular schematic convert tslin to eslin. So press enter, and here if you try to see, before running this one, what we'll try to do is, we'll try to run npm run lint. Actually, we have already run, I think. I don't know. So let's try to run npm run lint. I will show you how the linting will run first before that one. So it is running Angular world lint, ng lint it is trying to run. Okay, maybe it will be running on ts lint, I think. Let's try to see. So what is the thing it will be running? Now here you'll be able to see that TSLint support is discontinued and we are deprecating its support. Please use this convert the code layer. So this is the GitHub URL they are saying. So that means defaultly it will be running TSLint. Now it is telling that TSLint support is discontinued. Now we need to do this. We need to install this command. Now prior to this one, we'll again install this command. Convert TSLint to ESLint. Here it will ask you an option. Which project would you like to convert from TSLint to ESLint? So just give your project name, angular-world. Okay, so this is the project name I am having, right? So just give the project name. If you want to find your project name, means in the angular.json you will be able to see that project name. Here you will be having this project. This is the Angular world. This is the project name, like this. You can also able to find. So here it is creating eslint-rc.json, updated angular.json, everything is completed. So eslint-rc.json has been created and also it has been converted also. So if you try to see here, you will be able to see all the options here. Okay, so this is the thing. And also if you try to see, what I can say is, in the angular.json, if you go to the angular.json, where is this angular.json? Yeah, okay. If you try to see here, linting option, if you go to the lint here, see builder, it is using the builder, angular eslint builder lint it is using, and the lint file patterns it is using star, something like that. In the angular 12 version, how we have seen, it has changed here. And now here in this eslint-rc.json, what I can tell you is, here you can remove these all the things. Okay, so you can remove this one, and also here you can use something like recommended. So use the recommended. Okay, so this is the recommended. I can tell you to use this one. So now let's say we have did this one. Now let's try to run the npm run lint here. Npm run lint, I am using the npm run lint. So let's see what it will take. So we should not get this type of thing, tslint support. Why? Because right now we are having eslint. So it should run, the lint should run, the ESLint should run now. So let's see what it will run. See, now we are not getting any errors, and here TSLint support is discontinued. This error is not coming. So that means it is running the ESLint. Now let's try to see. Let's go to the source file. Okay. In the app component.ts, I can use here. And what I will try to do is, here I will write ng on init without implementing this interface. So I will write ng on init console.log something like hi Leela web dev. Okay, I have used it like this. That's it. Now let's try to do the linting. So will this throw any errors or not? Let's try to see. So it has been saved. Let's try to see it will throw any errors or not. Now see, we got an error that lifecycle interface on init has not should be implemented, and this one is coming from the angular-eslint. You'll be able to see here that it is not coming from the tslint. We are getting it from the eslint. Fine, right? So now I can do something like implement. Okay, so what I can write, implements on init, ng on init. Okay, sorry, on init, right? On init. Why this one is not coming? Okay, we'll write on init. Okay, now let's try to see whether we will get any errors or not. So I am doing npm run lint again. See, it has passed all the linting. Okay, so this is how we will be using this eslint rc.json in the old in the prior to Angular 12 version. So this is how we will be using. Now right now it is passing everything. So this is how we will be using this ESLint. Hope you understood how to install the ESLint in the older Angular versions. So this will give you a good idea. I hope that this will give you a good idea how to install the ESLint. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, please do support me by subscribing to my channel. And also please do follow my Facebook page also, Leela Web Dev. So description is provided, the Facebook link is provided in the description below. In the next video, what we'll try to do is we'll try to change the ESLint file both in the old Angular and also in the new Angular. I will show you how to write your rules. So same thing, custom rules also, same thing you can do it. So let's try to see it in the next video. Thank you.